Alright, 7th grade, lesson 107. This one is on slope. Now, in order to help me have good graph paper and me not draw it, I'm going to put this up on the board, and I'm hoping we're going to be able to see it well. Okay? So, first thing I want you to see is that whenever we, I don't have to use this right now. I'll use it in just a minute, so I'll put this down for a second. Okay, so the first thing I want you to notice is, I'm just going to draw these real quickly because there's something I want to teach you without being very detailed. Okay, if you see a line that goes like this, okay, or it could go like this, or it could go like this, or it could go like this, okay? Those are the four different lines we're going to look at, okay? Now, first thing I want to tell you is that whenever you're reading one of these graphs, whichever one you're reading, you always read like you're reading a book, from left to right. So if I was reading from left to right, which way is this arrow going?
Right.
Yes, but what direction? Up.
Yeah.
Right? So this one is going up, whereas this one, if I'm reading from left to right, is going down. And the good thing about learning to read it from left to right is the most important thing, because let's look at this, and if we read it from right to left, this one would be going up, and right to left, this one will be going down. So it's very important that you learn to read it just like a book, from left to right. Now, let's talk about the other two, okay? Now, the first thing I want you to see is we would say this one is going up, this one is going down. And the way that we would describe this one and this one is this. The horizontal one is going to be zero. And the reason why it's zero is it's not going up or down. You see that? So it's not going anywhere. It's just nothing. This one, on the other hand, cannot be determined because it's both going up and down. So you put cannot be determined. Okay? Got it? That's how we're going to say it. So this one does not go up or down, so therefore it's nothing, zero. This one you can't tell because it's going both up and down. But this one we can read, it's definitely going up, and this one we can read, it's definitely going down. Okay? Now, I also want to show you that when we are going up, it's always going to be a positive slope. It's kind of like a ski slope, for example. This would be a perfect description of a ski slope. I would be going down, right? And just like, let's think about a thermometer, okay? Beautiful. This is zero, this is 100. And if I went down, I would move into the negative numbers, right? Mm-hmm. Negative 20 if I go down. So guess what? All of the ones that are going down, you're going to get a negative slope. So you may want to write this down. If you're going up, you're going to get a positive slope. If you're going down, you're going to get a negative slope. A negative answer. Okay?
Yep.
If you're going horizontal, the answer is zero. If you're going vertical, you say it cannot be determined. Okay? So those are the four things you need to know. So today you're going to be learning about slopes, all right? Now, this is where I'm going to draw some on that piece of paper and check and see when I put this up, Eli, if they can see very well on here, okay? All right, I'm going to draw two charts at first. So here we go. On your paper, what I want you to do is draw a chart, and it might help you to also have a graph paper, so pause it and get you a graph paper.
You, the people.
Okay, so go on and get you a graph paper. Okay. All right, thank you. Sorry, I should have. Okay, you got some graph paper?
Yeah. Okay, we'll pause it.
All right, I went on and got mine ready. I have four of them because we're going to be drawing four grids up here. So, the very first one that we're going to draw, and I want you to stay with me, is, let's see, we're going to go over 2 from 0, and we're not going to go up at all. So, put you a dot right there, just over 2 from 0. Okay? Then from that one, the next one we're going to graph is going to be 4, 3. So, 4, 3. Okay, so 4 means you go to the right 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4. And positive 3, because this is positive, you go to the right. Positive 3, you go up. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, up, 1, 2, 3. And there's my dot. All right? And then the last one that we're going to graph is going to be 0, so we're not going to go left or right at all. We're going to go 0. And then we're going to go down negative 3. So 0, negative 1, 2, 3. Okay, once you have that, what I want you to do is take something and draw you a line with those dots. Okay? Okay, perfect. Now, once you have that line, I'm going to share some things with you, okay? The first thing I want you to see is, if I were to keep going, you see these dots that I have? Mm-hmm. Okay? I want you to count how many times, okay, first of all, let me ask you this question. Is this graph going up, down, horizontal, which is a 0, or vertical, which is undetermined? Which one?
Up.
Up. Okay. Because it's going up, we know the answer is going to be what? Positive. Okay. So, we know that this is going to be positive. Okay. When you're learning slope, write this down. Slope equals rise over run. Okay? Rise over run. And that's going to be a formula you need to know. Rise over run. Now, rise could also mean fall because rising something is going up. But it can also be a fall. So you can kind of see it like that. Running, obviously, I run left or right. I don't run up. Okay? So rise is this way or this way, up or down. Run is this way or this way. So now stay with me. Let's look at this dot right here, the one on the bottom. How much am I rising before I get to the next dot? So I'm rising 1, 2, 3. I went up 3. You see that? And I went over, I ran 1, 2. Do you see how I did that? It's almost like a triangle. I'm not trying to make it a triangle, but we're going up 3, over 2 to get to that dot. Up 3, over 2. And guess what? From this dot, what we're going to do? We're going to go up 1, 2, 3, and over 1, 2. See what's happened every time? Guess what? I can do another one. Up 1, 2, 3, over 1, 2. Got it? I can put another dot. Okay? So I can literally keep going. Okay? You can keep going up 3 over 2, up 3 over 2, up 3 over 2, and just keep making a longer line. All right. Now, so as you can see, our slope is positive answers. There's not a negative number because we are going up. We got positive answers. Good. Now, let's talk about the next one. Now, I'm just going to draw a line, okay? So let's pause it for a second. All right, I got mine all set up. Okay, I drew 4 lines, and we're going to talk about them in just a second. So let's look at this second one for just a minute. Okay, this second one, what I want you to do is every time you see that it crosses and makes a perfect cross right here, see that dot? It makes a perfect, it's right on, it goes right through that crossing point. See that? All right, where's another place it goes through that crossing point? I see another one. Right there. There's a dot. I see another place it goes through. It makes a perfect plus or cross. Okay, I see another one right there. And another one. And another one. So everywhere you see that it's crossing right through in between a cross, like here's a cross, and if it goes right through it, then that's where you mark a point. What? What? Okay, so once we draw through it, the way we can tell what our slope is, that was last time's, is from every crossing point, we're going to count up, rise, and run, okay? But first of all, determine this. This is going down, right? Yes?
Yes.
Yes. So a down one, if you're leading free from left to right, we know that it's going down. So my answer is going to be what right here? A positive or a negative answer? It's going to be negative. So I'm going to write negative. That helps me to know that that's what's going to be. All right, so let's read this graph from right or from left to right. So in order for me to get from this dot to this dot or this dot to this dot, however you want to do it, we're going to go from this way down. So we're going to start with this dot. I'm going to go down one over two. Down one over two, down one over two, down one over two, down one over two. That's what's happening every time. So I'm going down one, negative one, over two, which gives us a negative answer, which is exactly what we thought it would do. So from this, we're going down one over two, down one over two, down one over two, each time. That helps us determine our slope, okay? Now, these ones are just copycats of this one, okay? And so I don't need to do anything like that. Now, if it helps you to draw, for example, I guess that's what I could use this for. Everywhere this crossed, there's a crossing point, there's a crossing point, there's a crossing point, and there's a crossing point where they meet together in the middle. What you're going to do is if it helps you, you can always draw a triangle from one to the other. From this one to that one, from this one to that one. And therefore, you know, I go 1, 2, 3 over 1, 2. Up 1, 2, 3 over 1, 2. So this one's an up 3 over 2. And we know that since it's going up, that is going to be a positive answer. So this one is up 3, rise of 3, run of 2. Up 3, run of 2. Up 3, run of 2. Got it? Mm-hmm. Any of those. All right. So that's how you do that. Now, let's look at a new chart. And I've got it right here. This is our last one we're doing. Okay? So let's look at this one together. Now, I've already got my line drawn on here, okay? And so I'm asking you, what is my slope? And what is the formula for slope? Rise over run. Rise is up or down, run is left or right. Rise over run. All right, so every place it crosses, I am going to put a dot. I've got a crossing point there. Got a crossing point there. I've got a crossing point there, 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 and it just keeps going, okay? So those are my places that it crosses. Now, because it's going up, what's my answer going to be? A positive answer. That helps me. Now, all I'm going to do is go draw my little, and I can do as many or as little as I want. But basically, I'm showing the slope that it's going. It is going up 1, 2. 2 is my rise. What is my run? 1, 2, 3. Up 2, 1, 2, over 3. Up 2, over 3. Up 2, over 3. Over and over and over. All right, so that's what you're going to be working on today. So your very first thing is to make sure you insert your dots everywhere it crosses the T or the cross. And then you're going to determine what your slope is. You can use it by drawing triangles. Now, in the very beginning of the lesson, it taught you something, but I did not feel like it was something that needed to be taught in the very beginning. So I'm going to teach it now. And the way I want to teach you is we can do a chart for something like feet to yards. And what I mean by that is how many feet are in a yard? There are 3 feet in 1 yard. So I'm going to show you something. Let's just do this graph right here. Okay? Let's just use this side of the graph. And I'm going to number this number of yards. And this one I'm going to do number of feet. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right. 1 yard is how many feet? So 1 yard, let me put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now this is feet and this is yards. Okay, we know that 1 yard is the same thing as 3 feet. So when they come together, it's right there. 1 yard, 3 feet. 2 yards would equal 6 feet. Two of those, two threes makes six. So 2 yards, 6 feet. All right, let's try one more. 3 yards equals 9 feet. So 3 yards, 9 feet. See that? Now, let me draw my line. Okay? Now, I can ask myself, remember you drew your little triangles. How much am I going up every time? 1, 2, 3, and over 1. Up 1, 2, 3, over 1. Up 1, 2, 3, over 1. And that will be the next one. So, do you see the rise on this one is 3, and the run is 1. See that? Okay, so that's using feet to yards. That's just using something common, okay? And I could have been yards to feet and done it the other way around, okay? All right, that is lesson 107.